Good morning, students. We are here with the next poem, The Voice of the Rain by Walt Whitman. This poem presents a dialogue between the poet and the rain itself. The poem presents the cyclic movement of the rain. The poem is personified to describe herself, and it describes what she is and what blessings she showers on earth and men. The next is the introduction about the author. Walt Whitman had so many feathers in his cap. He was the American poet, an essay writer, and journalist. He was a part of the change between different type of poetry, and he incorporated that change in his poetry also. He was one of the most influential poets of that time, and he was also known as the father of free verse. The next we are talking about the poem. It is a short free verse poem by Walt Whitman, and it was officially published in 1885 and then reprinted also. In the voice of the rain, the speaker listens to the personified figure of the rain. It describes every stage of the water cycle, and the poem pays homage to the restorative power of the natural world and claims that poetry nourishes humanity just as rain nourishes the earth. The first stanza goes like this. And who art thou, said I to the soft falling shower, which, strange to tell, gave me an answer, as here translated. I am the poem of earth, said the voice of the rain. Eternal, I rise, impalpable, out of the land and the bottomless sea. The explanation part goes like this. The poet asks the soft falling shower of the rain, who art thou? What she answered to the poet is strange to tell in words. She gave an answer which is translated here. The voice of rain answers that she is the poem of the earth. She rises out of the land and bottomless sea upwards, untouched and unseen. The second stanza goes like this. Upward to heaven, whence, vaguely formed altogether, changed and yet the same, I descend to love the draughts, autumnies, dust layers of the globe, and all that in them, without me, were seeds only, latent, unborn. The explanation part goes like this. The rain rises out of the land and bottomless sea upward to the sky. There in the sky, she takes its birth or shape in a very vague form. Though the form is completely changed, that is, from vapors to rain, yet she remains the same. The showers fall down to wash the draughts, fine particles and dust layers of the earth. Everything seems to be very clear with rain. Without rain, the seeds lying in the earth remain hidden or unborn. They sprout to life only when it rains. The third stanza goes like this. And forever by day and night, I give back life to my own origin and make pure and beautify it. The poem talks about day and night endlessly the rain gives life back to the place of her origin, that is earth. She makes the earth pure by washing down all dust and impurities. It also beautifies it. The rain is the song of the earth. She rises from it like a song upwards, and after completing her operations, come back to the earth with love, without caring whether someone hears or notices her or not. Now next, we will talk about the summary of the poem. The poet writes the conversation he once had with the rain, and as it dropped gently from the heaven, that is sky. The poet asked, "Who are you?" And strangely, the raindrops replied, and that is translated just to, for the understanding of the readers. "I am the poem of the earth," said the rain. The rain adds, "as it is born in the form of invisible and intangible vapors that rise eternally from the earth's land and deep water bodies. It reaches the heaven, that is sky, and changes its appearance, that is, it is into different shapes. And it remains the same as it was in the at a birth time, but it changes the shapes just for a moment. Then it returns to the earth as little water drops, which wash away all the impurities of the land. The new plants find their life in it. Otherwise, without rain, they would have remained hidden or unborn inside the land only, mere as the in the form of seeds. And this life cycle ensures that the rain returns to its origin, the earth, giving it life and making it pure and beautiful. As it purifies everything, it washes out impurities and dust from the land." The poet realizes that the rain's life is similar to that of any song or the poem. A song's birthplace is in the poet's heart. As the poet writes a poem for the first time, in the same way, the rain takes birth from the land for the first time. And once the rain completes its cycle, come back to the land only. In the same way, the song or the poem, it passes from one person to another. It may change also, and it remains the same also as it travels from one person to another. But one day it returns to the poet with all due love of the listeners. In the same way, the rain takes birth from the land and it goes up to the sky, take a different shapes, and then again come back to the land. As the same way, the poem take some changes, but at the last, it is of the poet. It remains the same from inside. Now we will talk about the poetic device used in the poem. The first is the rhyming scheme. It is written in the free verse, as we have talked earlier also, so there is no rhyming scheme in this. The next is personification. The poet used a non-living thing as a living thing in the poem, that is the water. The poem, the rain is personified. "I am the poem of rain," said the voice of the rain. Rain is being personified. That means a non-living thing is being taken up as a living being. Metaphor, that is the indirect comparison between the qualities of different things, like "I am the poem of earth," and rain is being compared to the poem. Hyperbole, then when we exaggerate something, statements, that is bottomless sea. Sea cannot be bottomless ever. Next, imagery, visual description of something. Soft falling shower. The shower, the raindrops are being talked about as soft falling. This is the vocabulary used in the poem. I hope, students, you were able to understand the poem and the content given. Thank you so much.